And good morning, country mouse walkers, and welcome to the Thornton Reservoir in Leicestershire. And how's that for a beautiful view first thing in the morning? So it's about 8 o'clock in the morning. It's about 7 degrees, 44 Fahrenheit. And we're going to take a walk around the reservoir. What three words are fatter, glance, unroll? And of course, I'll put that in description as normal. As you can hear, we've got some very noisy ducks about. We've got a gentleman out on a boat over there. Never been here before, so let's go see what we can find. This outlet here from the reservoir, that goes into Rotherley Brook and it goes under the road off towards the east. If we go out here on the road, you'll be able to see the wall of the dam, which was built in 1854. And it's 12 metres high, the dam. There's Rotherley Brook. It's again. So it looks like the first part of the path follows the road. Morning. It's an early Sunday morning. You can see all the sheep out in the fields. And it feels a bit cold. I know it's 7 degrees, but late May. You'd think it'd be a bit warmer than this. If you are coming here, car park is free, where we started off from. Very, very small. It's quite full when I got there this morning. So a lot of people park in the village, which is allowed, but I don't know how much the residents appreciate it. We're quite quiet at the moment this time on a Sunday morning, but sure, get busy later. Mind you, they have forecast rain from 10 o'clock, so maybe not. We will see. Just coming to the end of our walk down the dam wall. So that's 500 metres, the wall, full length is. I did notice this sort of parking spot earlier when I drove past. Nearly came back and parked here. But thought I'd try the car park first. So here we go, back into the walk round the reservoir. We've had a lot of rain over the last few weeks, strong winds. Storms, I haven't been able to get out really, so it's great to be able to go and do a long walk. Hello, girls. Hello, smile for the camera. A few calves in there, so they'd be a bit twitchy. So, I don't know much about this place, just a quick look this morning. So we've walked down the road next to on the side of the dam. It is about 76 acres, the total of the site, built in a valley on the edge of the Charnwood Forest. It was originally, there's a water treatment centre that was built on the south side of the dam, and it can hold, when full, about 1.3 million cubed metres. You've got to admit though, what a lovely view. So, quite a big area. Opened to the public in 1997, and the path we're walking is about 4.5 kilometres long and would take you about 40 minutes thereabouts if you were walking quickly, that is, I think. Two or three walks. This is the longest that goes around the reservoir. There's a couple that go through the woods. Some are easier than others, so suitable for young children, wheelchairs, people steady on their feet, plus those who like to stride out a bit more. And although we're in Leicestershire, which is quite hilly region, with it being a reservoir, it's quite flat around it for those on a treadmill. Like they're fishing out there on the boats. Apparently it's a popular fishing area. Whether you can see them. They getting their breakfast. Now please don't ask me if they're swifts or swallows, because I get confused all the time. Every year I have to look up and see how you identify them between them, and every year forget by the next. Just know they're beautiful to watch. As you can see, it doesn't take long to cycle around. That's the cyclist we passed earlier. Little bit of a breeze. I hope that's not interrupting too much. I do love an old tree log. So many things live in them. Get them. I don't know whether you can see them. The little babies with their mum. Stunning. Oh, tiny little cygnets there. Squirrel running down the fence over there. Goes. Well, they did say rain by 10, but it's really clouding over already. So it looks like the last of the sunshine we had right at the beginning, and it wasn't very bright then. So Kat and Kerry from Team Valhalla channel, if you haven't seen it, you want to check it out, it's brilliant. My luck's rung out on the sun. They said I'd become, well, I said I'd become a bit of a sun weather stalker, trying to get good weather for videoing, but I might be running out this time. Just taking this walk a lot slower than I would normally because it's so beautiful out here. And apart from the cyclists, I've only seen a couple of other people, even though the cars were in the car park. But I'd say it's only a small car park. Like a new build going up over there. What a view they're going to have. Amazing. I don't know whether you can see. There's a duck over there. She's got some little ducklings with her. Do love springtime. I love all seasons really. There's something special about everyone. That spring sort of, I think, bursting with life is amazing. Ooh, can we get a bit closer to the water? Ending up in the water would be an advantage. So you're very, very close here to the M1, and M69 is the south to west of Leicester. It's not, I'm afraid I haven't got a lot of information because I didn't know I was coming here until late last night. It was just an idea I had last minute, knowing I'd got a few hours to kill this morning before meeting one of my sons later on. And I thought, yes, I know what I'll do. So sometimes I have a lot of information about places, and other times it's just admiring the view. Another great old stock. I do love it when they feed them. All sorts of mammals and insects. sure what those pond... Oh, we can see the ducklings now. I hope they're just there. I don't know what those pontoons are for, but probably... I don't know whether you can swim here in the summer. Certainly you can go out on boats and certainly fish. Got some very noisy geese over there. And they're very big. Goose, gander, turkey, not sure. I wish I'd brought my gloves. It is cold. Fingers are bitter. Feels more like April than May. I think the months swapped themselves over this year. Not the biggest of the reservoirs I've been to. Honestly, coming to the end of it. Here running water, but I can't get any closer to it, I don't think. Not without tackling a lot of nettles. Should I brave it? Looks like there's a pond at the end and the water just runs into the reservoir. And there. Morning. Looks like there's a pond there, and then the water runs off from that pond into the reservoir. From here we can see right the way down, all the way down the reservoir. jaw. Bird of prey above us. I'm trying to. Looks like he's got a youngster with him. Or her. Can't quite see them well enough to capture them. Obviously a river runs into there. It's run into there, fill the pond, and then it's filtered into the reservoir. Wonder if it's a form of car or whether it's a natural stream. Looks like there may be a track that way, but I can't see any arrows to follow. So, just been talking to a couple locals, and they think that the bird of prey I was trying to see looks like it's a looks like it might be a red kite, which are quite, we've got quite a few round us at home in Lincolnshire, but apparently they haven't got many round here, and they just spotted it out in that direction when I bumped into them. So that'll be good if they've not got many in this area, and then suddenly they have started to grow in numbers. suddenly looks like it's getting busier now. There's a lot of runners about. I can hear people talking. Obviously, it's not that far across. So here's where the water... obviously moves, filters down into the reservoir. So we're... that's the word I was trying to think of, and it's got a sign there saying do not try and cross it, which is always sensible advice. Morning. One thing I do love about getting out and about walking is everyone you meet seems to be pleasant, friendly. They do sometimes look at me as to say, what's she doing? I think I've only ever been asked once. So I don't know whether that's a British thing where we sort of look and don't say anything. Be interesting to see when you go further afield. I love these benches. And it's spitting a little bit with rain. Not a problem, we'll keep going. I'm waterproof, camera is to a certain extent. Hopefully we'll get all the way round the reservoir before it does rain properly. Wind's picking up as well. Morning. So I can see the car park from here over in the distance, so not that far away. Next, the wood we're walking past has got trails through it, which will be obviously the woodland trails I've mentioned earlier. So I think what I might do, seeing as it's only spitting about, is do a walk through the woods while I'm here. Why not? Car park actually looks a bit emptier than it did when I pulled up. Maybe everybody comes earlier. What a great tree. Happens to make them grow like that. I know a few places, one of my favourite places in the Isle of Man, all the trees are on an angle at the top of the hill, and that's because of the constant wind. I believe that the Falkland Isles, there are a couple of forces people I know have said all the trees point in one direction because they're constantly bombarded by strong winds. There's our fisherman. Nobody's caught anything. Moorhen out there. Birds are just so full of song. It's beautiful. Great family room there. Dog, mum, dad, baby and buggy. Perfect. Well, it looks like there may be another car park as well. Maybe that's connected with that building there, possibly. Actually walking away from the car park I came in at. So I'm presuming that there's a bit more of this lake yet, reservoir to come. So I think what I'm going to do is I think I might go back and film in the wood and finish my walk on the other side of the reservoir back towards the car park. So in that case, thank you everyone for walking with me. Thank you so much for taking the time to visit, enjoying this virtual walking tour. And I look forward, I hope, to you coming back again and spending some more time with me. So keep well everybody, look after yourselves, please like, please subscribe, and please take care. Bye.